every once in a while, as somebody will say, you know, no offense, but you look like Janine Garofalo. No offense, but I'm like, well, none taken. And then sometimes they'll say, whatever happened to her? When they don't know that it's me, and then I'll say it's me, and they'll say, why did you quit acting? Which is like getting punched in the face.
The reason I do stand-up is because my parents didn't really show me enough affection, which I think is what kind of comes down to why most people do stand-up, or showbiz in general. But the thing is, like, if you didn't have shitty parents in the world, you wouldn't have an entertainment industry. So when you see, like, a parent on the street, you know, like, like yelling at their kid or saying they're a loser or like punching them, like you might say that they're a horrible person, but they're kind of keeping showbiz and the entertainment industry alive. I did stand up for about 11 years and I really liked it. I had some really good success at it. Like I got a bunch of, you know, TV things and I was acting and things were going well, but then it just kind of stopped. And I didn't really like the direction my career was going, so I stopped and I was gonna try and do something else. I was gonna try and go to law school or something, but I don't know. I didn't really know what I didn't want to be a lawyer.
I'm dating a girl and we're doing this thing right now. You ever done this? We're making lists of celebrities that it's okay for us to have sex with if the opportunity arises. It's clearly a very healthy relationship. I haven't finished my list yet because I've been too busy trying to get her sister and her best friend record deals.
This is kind of my last shot, I think. Because I don't really know what to do with my life at this point. I don't really know what else I can do. You know, I'm approaching 40 rapidly and my job for the last, you know, 11 years or so was basically being a wise ass on stage. And, you know, once you're almost 40, you know, once you hit 40, you can't really go to the help wanted section and try and just get a legit job. You know, like, there's no classifieds. It's like, hey, we're looking for a sarcastic asshole to make fun of people at the law firm. Or we just want a guy at our doctor's office to talk about his balls. So I really need this CD to do something.
I always liken it to being like a high diver. You know, the first 1,000 times you get up there, you're just way fucking up in the sky. It's terrifying every time you get up there.
All comics feel like this is the wrong thing that I'm doing.
You're a huge asshole to want to be a comedian in the first place.
So much like, fuck you, no, you can't, no, who do you think you are? You're not famous enough, you're not popular enough. People really don't want you to make it.
I could liken it to when you're at the clinic and you're going in to get your test results.
I used to get cold sweats.
During it,
you can feel yourself sweating.
I've been doing it for over 20 years. So, the first 6 years, completely terrified. I would compare stand-up to a town hall dealing with Tea Party advocates. Like, there's a chance for it to go crazy, but you probably should be able to handle it, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, we need a comic, you're saying, for this gig? Yeah, I can't think of anyone. I mean, is Tommy Davidson around? Do you know his people? I'll take any comic at this point. Literally any comedian. Oh, I love pizza. You know what I put on my pizza? I'll tell you every single topping. Scallions. You ever get scallions? That's a weird one. Anchovies I've gotten. Of course I've gotten extra tomato. Okay, is that it? All right, great. All right, great, Beth. Thank you so much. Okay. No, thank you. All right, I love you, baby. Okay. All right, I love you.
Who was that?
That was my aunt. How are you doing, buddy?
I'm good. How you doing?
You look good.
I do? Thanks.
You look good. Like, for real good.
Yeah.
What have you been doing? You gained some weight?
No, I think I actually lost some weight.
Let me tell you something that I think you're going to like.
Okay.
This is a great time for you right now.
Is it?
Yeah.
Why?
This is a great time. Because things are pretty much as shitty as they can get for you. You're so irrelevant.
Yeah.
You're so cold right now that you're hot. Cheers.
your fucking heart.
Okay.
Right? Everything sucks for you, which means everything's great.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you're probably here, but that makes you here. You know?
Right,
you're totally
right.
Irrelevant. You've been out of the game forever.
Which means
you're in the game.
Okay.
What do you
want? So basically you said the opposite of whatever the first thing.
No.
No?
No, I didn't say anything that was opposite.
The stand-up is literally the lowest rung of show business, and right. We're below ventriloquists and magicians and a porn star that just kind of wants to try it. You're below him. You're below Steve-O.
People's biggest misconception about stand-up comedians is that they're funny. They're actually funny people, and they're actually not funny at all.
The biggest misconception that people have about stand-up comedy is that it's easy.
I had one goal, and that was to get on the David Letterman show. I started March 11th, 1995, and I did Letterman June 13th, 2012. Follow your dreams.
And I actually went back to being a lawyer for a while. I walked away from it because it was too much. But I went back to law and I swore off comedy, and then 2 months later I was back at the clubs doing comedy like an alcoholic going for a drink.
Can't fucking quit.
Comedians really do have to do comedy. Like when people are like, Seinfeld's going back to stand-up, like, well, of course he is. He has to do it.
Look at me, laugh at me, clap for me.
Right.
I want to be seen. So that's a degree of narcissism, yes?
There is that thing saying, hey, dude, you don't know how to do anything else.
I'd say from about 92 to about 2002, I had a lot of opportunities and a lot of success. And then it went away, which actually felt more normal in a certain sense because...
when it went away?
When it went away, even though it hurt me terribly, and it still to this day hurts me to think about, oh my gosh, it just ended and I'm not as popular as I once was with, you know, certain people,
right.
Or casting directors or directors. So that hurts my feelings because it feels personal. It may not be personal, but it feels personal. But then in another sense, it was like, oh, I always suspected no one liked me.
I stopped doing stand-up for about 18 months and I got back into it because I didn't know what else to do, you know, like, you know, going to job interviews and telling them you did stand-up for 10 years is about as useful as a felony conviction in the real world. The reason I got back into it was because this guy approached me about recording another album.
I first saw Tom about 8 years ago at a show in the East Village. He was amazing. I mean, easily the best on the show. And there were some famous people on the bill that night. I mean, he killed it. Literally, he killed. There was a girl who hung herself during the show. That's how funny he was. This guy could be big. With the right backing, with the right material, the right promotion, this guy could be bigger than Arsenio.
Oh, Tom McCaffrey should be way more famous than he is. Clearly more famous.
He's definitely one of the funniest guys in New York City. And if you're one of the funniest guys in New York, and there's not that many funny dudes. There's literally 10, and he's one of them. And the other 9 are millionaires right now and on television.
When I was 10 years old, I appeared on the Oscars. It was 1984, Johnny Carson was the host. And I danced with like 50 other kids to the song, What a Feeling, which was a song from the movie Flashdance by Irene Cara. I think it was there that I kind of got hooked on the idea of being in showbiz and being famous, or I don't know, just being in the entertainment industry, because I didn't know anything about it and it seemed really easy at that point because I was 10 years old and I was already, you know, hanging out with like Jack Nicholson was there and he came up to me and made some comment to me about like how great we had all been. And he had his Oscar in his hand. So I was just kind of like around all these Oscar winners. So I was like, wow, this is gonna be easy.
Let's talk about TV shows.
Okay, can you get me on some TV shows?
What kind of TV show do you wanna get on?
Well, I wanna do, you know, like a late night TV show, maybe.
What kind of late night? Steve Harvey show?
Steve Harvey?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even think he has a show. Does he?
He should. Have you thought about pitching the Steve Harvey show?
Why would I do that?
Name a show. Name a show you want to be on.
Okay, Fallon.
No. Name another one.
All right, Letterman?
No, I can't get you into those. Let's move away from comedy.
Okay.
I'm thinking like, have you thought about Bravo? Something that's maybe gay, lesbian friendly?
Can you just...
Can you give me any gigs?
I got you an audition for a Jamba Juice commercial.
Really?
Yeah. It's not actually a commercial. You're handing out Jamba Juice outside of a mall.
That's not a commercial audition at all.
If you want to get a job in real estate right now, I can hook you
up. I don't want to
do real estate. Do you have a real estate license?
No, I don't. I don't do real estate. Okay. Why would I?
It seems like you're pretty picky right now for where you are.
I'm trying to get ready to record this album. Can you get me a gig doing stand-up to get ready for that?
I've already got one lined up for you.
What are you even doing? Is that...
No, I can't log in. I got a show for you tomorrow night.
Yeah.
In an apartment.
In an apartment.
In front of 5 to 8 people.
And this is like a real thing?
Real artsy, real hip.
Do I get paid for that?
Well, I mean, look, man, you want to get paid or do you want to do comedy? People don't do both, okay?
They don't?
Hang on a second, let me crunch some numbers here.
What are you doing? You're just... what is that? You're
13 comics.
You just put...
13
that wasn't
comedians.
Even real.
What wasn't real?
What you did. You just like pretended like you were hitting keys or something.
I typed very fast. Look, Tom.
All right, well, when is the gig?
I'm not sure. I'm not positive.
Well, where is it?
I'm not positive about that either. But I can tell you something.
What?
Once I get the password to this computer, I will have all of that information for you, Tom. All right, I gotta go change the toner in the copy machine
okay,
in exchange
cool.
for using this office.
Okay.
You want a jug of water, buddy? This is a jug of water right here with your name on it. All right.
I don't really think I can.
Hey, you know. Take that. Give me 10% of it. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. But seriously, give me 10% of something.
Okay.
Hey, leave that jug of water here. You really can't have that.
It did not surprise me at all that Tom became a stand-up comic because he was a natural. That was the direction he was always going in. Oh, growing up, I mean, he could come in the room and everyone would just start laughing and cracking up. I mean, I remember one time he came in and he just told a joke and everybody just laughed. That's how funny he is. I really support Tom and his dreams. I literally support Tom and his dreams, starting with the cell phone bill I've been paying for the last 10 years. I literally support him and his dreams. So what I'm pretty much saying is if I weren't here, Tom McCaffrey wouldn't have a phone.
I just, you know, I mean, I do want to become famous so that, you know, like Scarlett Johansson will blow me. I feel like the driving force behind people doing stand-up and me especially is like, getting Scarlett Johansson, or whoever the Scarlett Johansson of the day is, to blow them.
You're up 18th, so we're gonna have you 18th, so that'll...
Okay.
Yeah, right, yeah.
How many people are on the show?
There's 18 people on the show. You're gonna
so
be
I'm
18th.
Last.
Yeah, we'll put you there because you're the strongest. That's the spot for you because you're strongest. So you're gonna be yeah. right after the ventriloquist, and that's right after the 20-minute intermission.
You guys have a...
So stoked to have you here.
Right, right.
Now you mouthing along with me, Sandy? Yes, I am. You know, there, I didn't do it. I didn't do it that time just because I didn't do it that time. You know what I mean? Because you guys get confused. I know how it is. You know, Let me speak, you know? So sometimes what I do is I don't mouth fully along while she's
All
talking.
All right, that was great, Candy and Sandy.
Thank you. I just wanted to finish up real quick. Thank you, guys.
That was pretty good. Come on the stage, very funny. Tom McCaffrey, everybody.
Woo! You go through phases, or even after bad shows, where you're just like, ugh, you know, like, there's levels of frustration or, you know, wondering, like, can I do this or do I want to do this?
You gotta pay in blood and, like, sweat and tears, and you gotta lose a lot of friendships. People lose marriages. I've seen comics lose their mind, man. I've seen people go off and never come back. The stakes get high.
This is what I realized. I realized that entertainment sucks. I think it's just labeled entertainment for, you know, show, but it really is the business. It's really more the business than the show. The show is just 10%. The business is the part that we have to learn how to get. It's that cutthroat shit that's going on.
I would love it if I was able to go back in and have luck again.
Right.
I would be really happy about that because it's very difficult when it goes away. It's just hard. And like I said, when you lose access to opportunity, it's painful. I mean, honestly, I can only speak for me. I don't know how other,
right.
But it's very painful to watch projects go by that you would love to participate in. And it's painful to watch people that you've worked with a bunch and that are your friends,
right,
moving on without you.
You know, I didn't go, I was away for about, you know, a little over a year, and it's just people kind of forget about you really fast. And yeah, it kind of sucks. It's kind of like starting over again, but I guess that's what you got to do. I mean, you can tell, like, when I see people, like, relatives and stuff now, you can just see in their face, they're kind of like, it's weird. I'll tell them I'm a stand-up, and because I'm older now, they almost look at me like I just told them, you know, I'm a breakdancer or something, or like a fucking pirate.
I'm having a weird week. I went to go see the new Tyler Perry movie in Harlem the other day, and I was actually thrown out of the theater for not talking.
What's my worst experience I ever had? The entire first 8 years of my doing comedy, I would say.
I did one show, which was, it was called New Jack Comedy on 125th Street. This is before, like, Harlem, everyone moved up there. Right? All African-American audience. And the guy was like, the MC was like, all right, our next performer, next comedian is a white guy. Boo! He goes, and he's a real white guy. This guy is really white. Like, double boo.
Hey, I'm Tom.
Thanks for doing the show.
No problem.
Here's your ticket.
Oh, is this for like a drink or something?
No, it gets you actually a dollar off cereal in the kitchen.
Oh, you guys serve cereal here?
Hell yeah!
So what is, this is
your
apartment?
Our club.
This is your apartment?
Oh yeah, we figure, what do people like more than anything in the world? Comedy? And apartments, and we couldn't get past at any other club. So
hey, man, what's up, King Ace?
What's your name?
King Ace.
Oh, hi.
Thanks for doing the
show.
That
was my dad's name.
Oh, yeah, really? Oh.
No, I'm just kidding. That's not. This is, where's the performance happen? Like, is this?
Well, there's a stage.
The
you know,
rug?
It's like any other club.
Right.
You got
Except
seats.
Not...
You got mics.
Yeah.
We got lights.
Now, so, being what? That it's 4:30.
Yeah.
People can get kind of rowdy, so
really
don't encourage it.
Do people come?
We usually cancel up to 3 shows a night,
right.
Sometimes 4 on weekends. We have one RSVP
tonight.
For this show.
Okay.
It's going to be the 3 of us. We have an email into Gaffigan.
Jim Gaffigan's doing the show?
No. Jake Gaffigan. He works at Duane Reade right down the stairs.
I get cereal in the kitchen or something?
Yeah, didn't I give you your ticket?
Yeah, you did.
You have to have the ticket to get it.
Yeah.
This is a bringer show.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Bring your own spoon.
Right, for the cereal.
Don't steal that, you know.
No, I will not steal that.
Guys, we should really try to start to get ready, I think.
For the show?
Yeah.
But no one's here yet.
No, will the green room be ready in like 5 minutes as soon as my uncle gets out of the shower?
Oh, okay. Your uncle's in the shower?
Guys, we should... Well, he's in the green room.
What?
We should be
he's in the green room?
Yeah.
All right, I think I'm going to go get some cereal. So can I have a cereal?
No. And the hardest thing about being 400 pounds is you're never not at Wendy's. Thank you. That was a Facebook status by Ralphie May.
Yeah, I used to date this girl. She could have been a model. Yeah, she was that stupid. So you guys, this happened to me the other day. You ever get so drunk that you can't find your car?
Yeah.
Yeah, really? This girl knows what I'm talking about.
And that's why, when it's cold enough outside, every jacket is a life jacket. Thanks, everybody. Pick up my new album, Ace Hole. Comes out, I think, in a year.
Hey, all right. Hey, now.
Hi, nice to meet you. Great show.
Oh, thank you.
I'm thinking of doing stand-up, too.
Good luck. Keep writing. Have you been writing? I wrote for 3 years before I even got on stage. You could take an improv class, but I don't think that's going to get you anywhere.
You got any good gigs coming up?
Yeah, I'm opening for Mike Tilley at Chuckle Farts.
Who is Mike Tilley again?
The Till Man? He rocks this club. It's in the back of a Taco Bell on Staten Island.
Yeah.
Has he ever been on TV?
He did a spot on Carson Daly in 96. Crushed.
Oh, now I remember him.
Pays 3 chalupas and unlimited hot sauce. You want to come?
Yeah. How'd you get that gig?
I responded to some scratchity on the inside of a porta potty.
Ah, I gotta respond to more scratchity.
What is scratchity?
It's graffiti with keys. Hey, I got some good gigs coming up. I'm doing the Comedy Dump next Tuesday. 4 p.m. show, doing a tight three. Gotta bring six people, drink eight drinks, no pets, no chairs.
That's awesome. What bits are you gonna do?
I was thinking about opening with SpongeBob SquareBalls.
You just did my joke up there. I just did like five minutes before you.
What joke?
What do you mean what joke? You don't remember what joke?
No, I didn't even see your set.
I do a joke about masturbating, and then you do a joke about masturbating. Mine is about masturbating in the bathtub, and you don't think it's weird that then you go up like 5 minutes later and do a joke about masturbating.
Look, dude, I've never
shower.
Even seen you.
No,
just
that's
stand
bullshit.
Up. I've never
that's
seen
ridiculous.
You.
The odds of this happening are like one in a billion. Just
jerking
now,
off is a universal topic, idiot.
But it doesn't matter because how could you have thought of it? You were standing there.
Well, how does your joke go?
My joke?
Yeah. Knock knock.
No, it's not knock knock. It's cock cock in your mother's tushy. What about the other joke that you do about porn, which is exactly like my really good friend's joke?
Who's your friend? What's his
who's
name?
Who's my friend? Don't act like you don't know who my friend is. Turkey Balls. He was on first in the show. He did the same joke, and then you go
why
on.
Why would I steal a joke from a guy named
who cares?
Turkey Balls?
What, who cares? Just go home. No, I didn't stop
why
you.
Why don't you go home?
I'm going to headline a show at a laundromat, all right, loser?
I started a new Twitter account under an alias.
Oh, what is it?
At Mom Dumps. I have 80 followers right now, and if I have 20 more, I'm gonna move to LA and write a book.
What's the book gonna be?
Mom Dumps. It's a coffee table book. Pictures of moms taking dumps.
So a commercial for this pill to treat PMS. And at the end of the commercial, they're like, side effects include stomach pains, nausea, and irritability. I was like, that just sounds like PMS again. Like, you can't do that. You can't come out with a pill to treat something, and then the side effects are just the exact thing again, right? That's like if I came out with a pill to treat herpes, and I was like, side effects include super herpes.
Some of them are paid, but they, you know, like you'll do a show and it'll pay like $35, and I mean, fine, but you know, you can't live on $35.
A lot of the clubs would kind of come at you with this attitude that the clubs are your college. This is your opportunity to right. be seen and hone your craft. And it's like, well, someone's making a lot of money while we go to college, and how many years are we going to be in college for? I've done 3 or 4 Letterman sets. When do I graduate?
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
So it's like not everyone's going to win the lottery ticket of the Seinfeld, you know, path or Ray Romano. That's great, you know, but that's not realistic for everyone.
Tom was our nanny for years, so when we had our 2 daughters. So even though our children are both getting ready to go to college or in college, we've pretty much kept Tom as our nanny because we have to, he needs us to. And he would love for us to have another baby. He's actually been encouraging it so that he could remain our nanny. The last time I saw him, I caught him poking holes in my husband's condoms.
I'm back.
Oh yeah.
He's Woo. Back.
Yeah, comedy, baby.
I remember one time I was auditioning for a club. I'm not gonna mention the club because I don't want to embarrass him, but I was auditioning for a club in New York, and I did like a 5-minute set. And I did really good. It was a good set, I thought. And you know, like crowd-wise, it was a good reaction. And after it, they just said, ah, man, you're too green. I don't know, I don't like it. And 6 months later, I auditioned again and I had a little bit more heat on me. And I did the exact same set to audition with. And they were like, that was amazing. Clearly the guy was notorious for not even watching people that he didn't want to pass. So it was like a kind of a thing where it was a lesson in either they want you or they don't a lot of times. They're not really paying attention and really seeing what they can get out of someone. They just want to follow somebody that's got heat.
This is a great time. There's heat.
There's heat?
You know how many times a day I pick up this phone and it's like, Tom McCaffrey, Tom McCaffrey. None. Here's what I
mean, do you know anyone in like the business?
Do you know the Montreal Comedy Festival?
Yeah.
How about the Ontario Improv Festival?
No, I've never even heard of that.
Well, everyone will soon, once you do it. I got you.
Everyone's gonna know about it when I do it? I don't even do improv.
You don't?
No.
I do stand up.
Name a color.
Blue.
Yeah, you're right. You don't do improv.
Montreal, yeah, like 20 years ago was like the only comedy festival. And that was the only chance that industry had to see you if you were a nobody.
Oh, I just got the Montreal Just for Laughs Comedy Festival. Praise the Lord. Yo, I don't think God is in the comedy business, man.
Get to the Montreal Comedy Festival, get seen at the Montreal Comedy Festival, and the money was flowing like water for stand-ups. And I think that was due to the fact of success of Tim Allen and Brett Butler and all those people. Everybody knows the change. I mean, it's happened with The Chicken. With some guy named The Chicken at Montreal Comedy Festival. His big thing was fucking the stool to the William Tell Overture. And he got like $500,000. No, he killed himself like a couple years ago. Yeah. So it was...
Did he just not go anywhere?
He didn't go anywhere.
Listen, I gotta go do a thing. I gotta talk to Tootie from Facts of Life.
Tootie?
Big night for her.
Wait, why? Is she getting back into acting?
Oh, no. She's headlining Caroline's tonight.
She does stand-up?
Oh, she doesn't do stand-up, man. She does this 40-minute story about how Natalie once pussy-farted on the set of Facts of Life. Blow you away.
That story takes 40 minutes to tell?
I mean, there's a lot of build-up.
Like, what are some of the things there's she says in the story?
She talks about what Natalie ate that day. She did yoga earlier in the day. You can't open for her. This guy Turkey Balls is opening for her.
Who's Turkey Balls?
You don't know Turkey Balls?
No.
Turkey Balls is... insane. He tells these really heady jokes about how his balls look like turkeys.
It'll blow you.
If you had to compare his style to another comedian.
Seinfeld.
Okay. He's like Seinfeld?
He's kind of like Seinfeld if Seinfeld had balls that look like turkeys. You know, Seinfeld is prolific. Yes. Turkey Balls is prolific. They're both very smart.
But what is he? You just said all he does is tell jokes about how his balls look like turkeys. How is that prolific?
If you had balls that looked like turkeys, you wouldn't joke about that? What would you be joking about?
I don't
about
think I'd want people to know that. I would kind of just keep that to myself.
Yeah, we're developing a show about him, actually. It's called Turkey Balls, and it's about his balls. And
well, what happens in the
I don't know. I'm not the writer.
Well, can I be on it?
You can't be on it, all right? It was just booked up. I tried to get you on. They took the guy who shot Reagan instead.
How is that guy going to be on a show? He's on a TV.
They're setting up a green screen behind him. He's huge now, man.
Is he good
Everyone's
acting?
Calling me about him.
Is he a really good actor?
No, he's a terrible actor, but he's great.
When it comes down to your material and your stand-up, and it's not to say that, you know, agents and managers are not important, but it really comes down to the content, right?
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
Good, man. So you're Tim McElroy?
No, I'm Tom McCaffrey.
Oh, right. So first off, Jim, what killed your set for me right out of the gate was you thanked the host. You never thank the host. That's comedy rule number one.
Why not?
Okay. I mean, it's a comedy show, not a thank the host show. I mean, you're not hosting the Oscars.
Right. Does the host of the Oscars thank people a lot?
Yeah, it's the Oscars. He thanks people all night.
I thought it was generally the winners of the Oscars that thank the people, you know, like their agents. I thought the host...
No, it's the host.
Why would he thank people, though?
Because he's hosting the Oscars. You got huge laughs, you know, right. And you did great, and people loved your jokes. But I have to be very honest with you. I don't personally see anything about you that would in any way be interesting to anyone in the world.
Right.
I mean, no offense.
No offense? Oh, yeah, why would I be offended?
I don't think you should. The stand-up's not about telling jokes, okay? It's about making people look in the mirror and see themselves and think, who am I? That's what stand-up is about.
That's what it's about?
Yeah, I mean...
It's not about telling jokes to people?
No. I mean, my dog can do that.
Your dog can do stand-up?
You know, the thing about you is that you're a white guy.
Yeah.
And pretty much across the board, no white guys ever really make it in comedy. So.
They don't?
No.
Well, what about like Adam Sandler? He made it.
Adam Sandler? First of all, Adam Sandler is not that successful.
Well, what about like, not to belabor this, but like George Carlin? He was a white guy.
George Carlin?
Yeah.
George Carlin is dead. I mean, is that our definition of success?
I know, I was referring to more when he was like alive.
George Carlin was not
stuff.
A very successful comedian.
So who would, just out of curiosity, who would you consider to be a successful comedian?
You know, I mean, Mr. Magoo, that cartoon character, was great.
Well, you know, he is a white guy.
White cartoon.
Thinking this guy is a professional.
Yeah.
All right, like, he must know what he's talking about. But then after a while, like, it was very controlling. And I was like, it took the fun out of it.
You need to be vulnerable and open and honest and raw and witty and not white and younger and tragic and happy and sad all at once.
Like, who can do that, do you think, with comedians?
Adam Sandler is great at that. George Carlin was excellent at it. I know what I'm talking about here. I did stand-up for a while.
How long did you do stand-up for?
Like 3 weeks.
Where did you get up?
My friend's house, mostly.
Oh, your friend had, like, a comedy club in his house?
No, he just had a house. Who would have a comedy club in their house? My friend had a house. I would perform at my friend's house. Like, we would rent movies, and I would say funny things after the movies. During the movies. My point is that being funny just isn't enough anymore. I mean, this isn't the 80s. You know, you're gonna need a hook.
Criticism hurts me terribly. I don't have a thick skin about it. It doesn't roll right off my back. I would prefer to be well-liked.
That drink is not free.
Oh, really? They told me I got a free drink.
No.
I don't?
It's $12.
It's $12?
Yeah.
Okay, I guess so. Oh, I have to give you the $12?
Yeah.
You know, the entertainment industry is a lot of, come here.
People only look at the negative comments because those are the ones that agree with you on the inside. Like, that's how I feel about me too, that I'm worthless, I'm shitty. So when those people say I'm worthless, they're like, yeah. People are like, no, you're great, you're amazing. Like, nah, you don't really know what you're talking about. But that guy knows.
I got something for you, buddy.
What is it?
I have an unconfirmed meeting with a music television station. I don't want to say which one. VH1.
Yeah.
Because they are looking for pitches for spin-off shows.
Right. Really?
Now. Of their current shows.
Okay.
Guess who the executive is?
I have no idea. Who is it?
The son of Tootie from Facts of Life.
The son of Tootie is the executive?
Is the executive there.
What's his name?
I don't know if you want to meet with him or get his autograph.
Right.
Because that's exciting.
Why would I want his autograph?
Because he's the son of Tootie.
What's his name?
His name is also Tootie, actually.
So she named him after the character?
No. She named her kid after her great-grandfather, who also was named Tootie. It was spelled differently, though. It was the number 2 and then the letter T.
What is this meeting going to do for me?
I mean, they're producing content like it's nobody's business. The next project that they're working on is actually starring Tootie, being produced by Menudo, and it's called Tootie Cleans Toilets. Tootie's gonna go into several homes, start cleaning toilets.
It's being produced by Menudo?
Menudo, the group Menudo. I was like, why has this not happened sooner?
Why would Menudo want to be involved in a show about cleaning public toilets?
Why wouldn't they? It's hot right now,
Which
man.
Which Tootie is in it? The son or the mom?
Both. Both Tooties are going to be in it.
What's the name of the show?
It's called Tootie Cleans Toilets. And I was like, perfect name.
There was, again, the type of access that I used to have to certain things. Now, it seems almost inconceivable to audition for a studio film now. Like, I just can't imagine it happening anymore, or to even get an offer. Used to be, during the lucky period, it was just offer only. It's gone back now to even a level below, she's got to audition because no, I don't want to see her. How many movies can, and I love Paul Rudd, believe me, I am a huge Paul Rudd fan and have been for years. How many movies can you do?
Right.
How many times can I see the same group of funny guys in a group? The problem I have is not their fault. It's the casting directors and directors and producers above them who refuse to allow the possibility. And I'm not even trying to be a main person in a movie. I'm telling you, I'm talking about number 14 on the call sheet, if you're familiar with the call sheet. I don't even care if it's the role of the pizza delivery person.
Yeah, you're sort of perfect for this show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you're like perfect for
it. Oh, wow, great, great. So
I don't really have any say at the, you know, in the last.
Oh, you don't
have
any say?
But I'll definitely be pushing you hard for this. Like,
how does it work? Should I follow up or?
Yeah, I show them all the tapes, so definitely follow up.
Oh, like, did you tape the show?
Well, okay, so The camera battery when you got on stage kind of went out, so I don't really get to tape you, but...
Oh, okay. The camera battery died?
Yeah, I didn't put the camera in my bag because I was fiddling with my cat's dying.
So you didn't even have the camera.
I didn't even have the camera.
Oh, so it wasn't charged.
Wasn't able to tape you.
And it's not here. Yeah. So you...
Anyway.
But how will they know?
So I caught, you know, the last bit I saw was you nailed that shit.
Hard. The last bit of my set?
The last bit I saw.
How much? You didn't see it?
Yeah, I saw like the last 10 seconds and you were amazing. You nailed it.
Right.
You nailed it. You're solid.
The last
you're
10
so
seconds?
You're so solid. The last 10 seconds.
What did you like about what I did?
Hey, I'm Tom McCaffrey. Thanks so much for coming out.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You're so, it's not pushy. And you didn't fall, which is a plus when you left the stage.
Yeah.
So I'm definitely going to mention.
I've been working on that. You're going to mention that I didn't fall?
I'm going to mention that I didn't see your set, but I did see the last second where you did not fall.
So this would be a show. It'd be a lot lower budget, a lot simpler, wouldn't cost you guys a lot of money. It'd be like a funny show about pop culture and like people in pop culture and talk about how stupid they are.
Yeah, they're
stupid.
Because
you know, like celebrities can be dumb and stuff.
Yes.
You know,
yes,
and like,
yes.
Or like, oh, like, you know, some Amanda Vines farted, you know. Or you know how like Sean.
She farted.
Yeah, you know how Sean Connery's like getting old?
Oh my God.
You know,
yes.
Celebrities get old?
Yes.
It's like, look at them. Why are you getting so old? That's stupid.
I love that because look at how, like how Kim Kardashian's fat now.
Yeah,
right?
She's fatter.
Yeah, or look like how Lindsay Lohan looks like shit.
Honestly, I'm gonna be honest with you.
Okay, great.
Sorry. I think you're too old for this show.
How old is the age range?
Like, you know, 20-year-olds that look like they're 14.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
Or 14-year-olds. No.
14-year-olds that look like they're nine.
Yeah, right. That's why you're so funny.
Yeah, totally. So you might be into that, right?
Yeah, who are we gonna get to host?
Well, I would host it. I would be the host.
On the brakes there. Here's what my thinking is, that we get someone else to host. You know, just someone that's not you. If you can get Daniel Tosh, that'd be great. Even better is if you got Adrian Brody. He's amazing. And I'm thinking that this show idea works best when it's, you know, Daniel Tosh, Adrian Brody, not you at all. That's an amazing show.
You're just too old for it, dude. Let's not push you. I mean, I will push you, but let's not push
you. You'll push me, but I'm too old and you didn't see me.
This is good because actually I've got a lot of notes on our meeting and it's...
Those are your notes?
Hmm?
That's just a picture of a guy.
It's not just any guy. That's me as an angel.
That's you.
Getting a blowjob. My meeting, our meeting, where was I when I drew this?
Right.
I was here.
So that picture of the girl blowing the guy will remind you of the show ideas I had?
Yeah.
Come on, show them what you're worth.
I like that song. Yeah.
I mean, you're a little old for that song, but... Tom and I are very different, even though we're brother and sister. I have a real job. I'm very successful. I have a lot of money. And he doesn't have any of these things. But he's very, very funny.
Oh, man.
Look, everyone, this is my dick! Look at it!
One thing that's good is about being back in the scene is that I miss is there's like a camaraderie between other comedians.
Do you guys have a lost and found in here?
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Okay, because I lost this shirt, and I'm really perplexed as to what happened to it. It's like a blue and white flannel shirt.
I just want to say thanks.
Hey,
thanks a lot. Thanks so much.
Is it like this blue?
Yeah, it's kind of like that.
Oh, okay.
Hey,
what's up, man?
What's up, man?
You did your set tonight?
Yeah, I did. Where'd you get that shirt?
I got it at like Banana Republic, I think, or something.
Wait,
is this like a, do you want my shirt?
No, I don't want your shirt, but you don't think it's weird that like first you start stealing my jokes, and then you start stealing my clothes?
How did I steal my shirt. How did I steal your clothes?
You're wearing my shirt. Tonight you're wearing a Yankees hat. You don't think that's weird too? You're wearing my shirt, you steal my clothes, you steal my jokes, and now you're stealing my team. Now you're doing, you just want to dress like me. You look exactly like me. The way I
looked
on stage. I
don't look anything like you.
Yeah, 3 days ago before I lost this shirt, and before I called the cops and started this whole thing,
this is right. what I look like, and now you're looking like this.
Right, so I really don't have time for this. So.
Good, good. And you're not going to have time also when you're in jail. And you
oh,
know
I'm
what?
In jail? Yeah, are you a
yeah,
lawyer?
Yeah, you know what? No, but I am friends with a sheriff.
It's a good community. People really, they support each other. They help each other.
My ex-boyfriend has smelly balls. I don't want to name him by name or anything, but his name is Tom McCaffrey. Not Tom McCaffrey. So he has really smelly balls, and they're very hairy. He's an awkward guy. I mean, I don't know. You see him, and you know, sometimes he walks in, and he's wearing a leather jacket. He's got a backwards hat. You know, he looks exactly like that guy who's standing in the back right now. I do think that that's him. He went up first.
I mean, I understand she's angry, but I think she was being a little hard on me. She was saying my balls smell, but I mean, you know, balls, they don't have a good rep for smelling good, so I don't really know what to tell her. Is she like hooking up with dudes that have like these amazing smelling balls? I doubt it. Every dude she probably hooks up with has smelly balls. It's just, you know, the worse the breakup with a girl is, the smelly your balls get in her jokes.
Veggie cream cheese on bagels. I could put lox. I could put lox cream cheese. Just butter. I could just go with butter. All right. You want more? I gotta go.
Out of here.
On a work thing? Butter, just plain old butter. Sometimes, you know, you just go traditional.
Will I talk to you soon, though? Okay, I love you. I love you so much. I love you. 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 I love you.
Is that your aunt again?
No, that wasn't my aunt. That was Aunt, the comedian Aunt.
Okay.
Doesn't matter.
You
this
love
isn't
him?
About me. You're right. Not here for me, okay?
All right.
We're here for you, buddy.
Yeah, you called me in. I got
guess what?
What?
I got you a TV spot.
Really?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
What is it? Like Letterman or something?
Better.
Better than Letterman?
Better
what
than
is
Letter.
It? Than Letter?
Reality show.
A reality show?
Picture this.
What's it about?
People who have been attacked by ghosts.
Okay, what's the name of the show?
People Have Been Attacked by Ghosts.
Okay, that's a good title.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, you came up with the title?
I suggested it.
Really?
Yeah, they already had a working title.
What was the working title?
It was just Ghosts.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, you improved it.
What do you say?
I mean, I haven't been attacked by ghosts.
You could come up with a story. You're a writer, right? Here's some paper.
A story about what?
Write a story about a ghost that attacked you.
But first of all, is it even possible for ghosts to attack people?
Is it possible for ghosts to attack people?
Yes.
Are you kidding me?
No,
I don't think that's possible. Ghosts are out there. There's probably one in here right now. There's probably a ghost right here in there. Hey, ghost.
Just hanging out?
I don't know, maybe.
Why would a ghost hang out in your fucking office?
A woman died in here last year.
Really?
Yes. All right, she did.
I'm sure she just hangs out here then where she died.
Do you want to do this or not? Do you want to do the show?
Maybe, but I just don't think that that's a possibility that people can get attacked by ghosts.
It's absolutely a possibility. How about you go rent the movie Ghost and tell me that Patrick Swayze doesn't attack people in that movie?
But that's not based on reality.
It's a real movie.
It was
true. Based on a documentary.
The movie Ghost is based on
based
reality.
Based on a book, a real book.
What's the name of the book?
Ghost is based on a book that was called Ordinary People. It came out in the 70s. It was made into a movie.
The movie Ghost is based on the book Ordinary People.
Yes.
No, it's not. They made a movie.
Look, I don't have time to go over the whole Wikipedia page of Ghost here. Do you want to do the show or do you not
want
to do
the show?
What
does it pay?
It pays $20 and you get your choice of a sandwich on set. And they only have turkey right now.
Okay, well, is anyone else on it that's like any names on
Huge
it?
Huge names.
Who? Who's on it?
Huge names.
Like who?
Scott Hamilton. Remember
who's,
the figure skater?
No, who's that?
Oh, he's huge. Okay, Nadia Comaneci is in it. Remember the gymnast?
Yeah, neither of them, are they even in showbiz?
Yeah, they're great. The guy who stabbed a bunch of people in 1985 on the subway.
That guy's in jail.
He's out of jail and he's hot right now. And they got the guy who shot Reagan. He's in it. Huge thing you're involved in. Dick Clark is in it.
Dick Clark is dead.
Dick Clark plays a ghost in this. Remember it's about ghosts attacking people?
How did they get him?
They called his people. You know, they had a seance. They got him.
What's that going to do for me, being on a show like this?
What's it going to do for you? You do a show like that, all of a sudden you're in movies, then you're starring in movies, then you're Arsenio Hall. All working out for you.
I'm Arsenio. I don't want to be Arsenio Hall.
Of course you want to be Arsenio Hall, man. Everyone wants to be Arsenio Hall.
But he doesn't even do movies anymore.
He does a ton of movies.
What movies has he done?
Have you seen The Butler?
Yes, I did see The Butler.
Well, yeah. I didn't see it.
He's not in The Butler.
I don't know. Maybe he's in The Butler. Maybe
he's not. No,
there's a lot of black people in The Butler.
He's not in The Butler. I saw it.
So do you want to do it or not?
All right. I guess I'll do it.
You'll do it?
Yeah.
Okay. He'll do it. Okay.
What, so Ant is booking the show?
No. The guy who books it was on. He was waiting.
He just calls in the middle? Most of this.
I think what happens is, like, you get some chances, and then you're in your early, mid-30s, and if you don't kind of break to that next level, like having your own show or something, you can kind of just get lost in just doing spots.
I now have no access to opportunities, some of which I feel I do deserve a shot at.
I was kind of like a hot up-and-coming comedian, and I feel like I took it for granted at the time. And it's hard when you have that moment and then you maybe step away for a little bit, like I did. I stepped away, and then you come back, you expect it to be that again, and it's not. You have to work again to get to it, and that's really fucking hard. It's like I have this thing in the back of my head that I couldn't, like give this up. I couldn't let the dream die. You know, I told you I had that thing where I was on the Oscars when I was really young, and I feel like that part of me never died. That, like, right there, something like clicked in me. The experience hasn't been what I thought it would be when I was, 11 years old. Like, I didn't see all the pain and trials and tribulations I'd have to go through on that path. I told my mom, I'm gonna go back to the Oscars one day to pick up an Oscar.
I'm recording a CD,
I'm recording a CD.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I'm doing a double CD, actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. With the, that's a private single, though. That's great.
Yeah. No.
You only have enough material for one CD, right?
I'm doing another TV show.
What show?
It's VH1, about celebrities who pick their noses and stuff.
I do that show, yeah.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
I taped like 5 episodes.
I've done 10 episodes.
I'm talking to my manager about some other
who's
stuff.
Who's your manager?
He's this guy, his name's Cal Trunger.
Is that like your dad or something?
No, he's like a real
guy. Oh, he's
guy.
A real guy?
No, he's a guy, yeah.
My manager, he represents Denzel Washington, Tom Cruise, Christopher Walken, Penelope Cruz.
Oh, wow.
It's actually funny, I'll go to the office and they'll be like, hey, Cruz is here. I'll be like, which one? So what else have you been up to, man?
My friend just got, stabbed.
Got shot.
Really?
Twice. It's crazy, man.
I am dating this girl I was talking about before, and she's really into sex games. You guys into those?
Yeah.
There's this one game she likes to play all the time. It's called Sleep With My Friend Rob.
Yeah, I feel like I'm like one of the funniest and one of the best, but it hasn't come to me as easily as it's come to other people.
You know, there would be some jealousy, and it's because everyone's trying really hard, and it's frustrating. I mean, the weird thing about stand-up comedy is that of all the aspects of the entertainment industry, it is closest to a meritocracy. But that does not mean that it's merit-based.
I understand why people get upset, because it's a lot of unfairness in this business. It's not like sports. If you were an athlete, I was an athlete. It's not like finite. Like, if you're talented, you play.
Right.
If you suck, you sit on a bench.
Yeah.
That ain't like this here. I turned into that angry dude. I turned into that, like, I got mad. I see people on show. I'm like, why the fuck did they get that?
I was definitely jealous of people, and I like these people. I love my friends.
Oh, no, don't feel sad. I'm getting paid like $1 million for this. That's how much we get paid. That's how much they pay you at Caroline's when 20 people show up. This is actually part of my parole.
Boy, I always wanted to be on this craptastic show that it's just, they're just making sausage at a factory, churning out these shows because they get high ratings.
Yeah.
but that is not. And you'll see a lot of formerly very recognizable faces from huge movies and stuff. They didn't go there, you know, to these shows.
Right.
Willingly.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Thanks for coming.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Thanks for having me. I'm a huge fan of this show.
Oh, great, because I'm a huge fan of you. So tell me about your experience getting attacked by a ghost. This is Ghost Attacks, and had a great, you know.
Yeah, I have a great ghost attack story.
Awesome. Tell me all about it.
I was in my apartment, and this ghost just came in, and it was like, hey, it was like, get out of here, Tom, you know? And I was like, man, this is really scary. I'm like, there's a ghost in my house.
What did it look like?
The ghost?
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it just looked like a ghost. It was like a white sheet. A white sheet, yeah. And it had like holes in the white sheet, like for the eyes.
It had eye holes?
Yeah, you know like how ghosts have eye holes in the sheets?
Like when somebody dresses up. Like a ghost, you mean?
Remember that episode of the Brady Bunch where they're trying to like scare Cindy, and it looked like that.
It looked like the ghost from the Brady Bunch.
Yeah, like you know, or else from Scooby-Doo. Remember
the cartoon Scooby-Doo?
Yeah.
Well, tell me what it said. You mentioned it spoke to you. Tell me more about.
Well, it came in and it was like, "Look, buddy, this is bullshit. I'm a ghost. I want you out of this apartment. I died here. And now I'm gonna haunt you until you get out of
my place."
So
this is a legacy haunting. It's directed at the location.
It said that. It was like, I'm a legacy, you know, so get out of here.
Wow.
You know, it was like, I died. I was like, how did you die, dude? And he was like, I was on the toilet. He sat down next to me, you know, and then he started smoking my weed. And I was like, you're a ghost? And he's like, look, of course I'm a ghost. Remember that Brady Bunch episode? Like, I look like that ghost.
He talked about the Brady Bunch episode?
I don't know if I think he mentioned something about it. I think he was just trying to break the ice. So then he was like mad because I didn't have any nachos. And I was like, dude, what do you mean? You can eat? He's like, yes, ghosts eat. He was like, didn't you see Ghostbusters when that guy's eating? And I was like, yeah, all right. And then he'd start punching me in the face. It was like in that movie Ghost with Patrick Swayze. Like, remember Patrick Swayze's beating those guys up, even though he's a ghost? There's not even anyone here, and I'm getting punched in the face. Like, that's what I was thinking. I was like, this guy has a sheet on, and he's, you know, he's punching me.
Yeah, so the attack was like the movie Ghost, and the ghost looked like the Brady Bunch.
And then it farted at one point, so.
It smelled really bad in the room?
It already smelled bad in there because I just had like, you know, Chinese food that I didn't throw away, so.
Okay, you smelled a fart? Is that what?
No, I just heard it. It was like, and then he finally just left because he was like, you know what, dude? He's like, I gotta go take a dump, so he just left.
He talked about going to the bathroom as a ghost?
I guess, I mean, I don't. Maybe he was kidding. He said it sarcastic, so, you know.
You know, I got to be honest. I just feel like you've made this up.
What part?
The entire thing. I think you're making it up right here.
You think
while you're sitting here talking to me. It doesn't even make sense.
What doesn't make sense? I told you it came in. It looked like Scooby-Doo and the Brady Bunch. It wanted nachos. It tried to smoke my weed. What about this doesn't sound real?
The 100% of it, 100%. I wish we were paying you.
Why?
So I could not pay you.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, because you've wasted my time. I'm trying to do a serious show about ghosts that attack F-level celebrities.
Right.
And it's people like you that give this show a bad name.
Yeah, no, there were two ghosts, actually. The other one looked like Bill Cosby, like from Ghost Dad.
You've picked ghosts that are not threatening and have to do with some type of pop culture.
No, I just say these are what ghosts look
Cindy
like.
Cindy Brady
Cosby? No, it looked like Bill Cosby, like in Ghost Dad. Remember there's a movie Ghost Dad?
I'm familiar with the movie Ghost Dad, yes. I look.
And you know that was real. You know what, dude? I'm gonna level with you. I wasn't attacked by a ghost that looked like Patrick
Swayze. Oh, right, now the truth comes out. Now the truth comes out, yes.
Yeah. But I mean, everyone who comes in here for this show is making up stories. No one really was attacked by a ghost.
I was attacked by the ghost of Tupac last year in Harlem.
You were attacked by the ghost of Tupac?
Yeah.
In Harlem?
Yeah.
What did he look like?
He had a ski mask on.
And what happened?
And he had a lot of tattoos.
Yeah.
And he took my wallet.
Okay.
Yeah. That just sounds like you were just robbed in Harlem.
I don't have to explain myself to you.
I know, but you know what? Ghosts don't even exist, dude. So that's retarded.
Get out of here. I'm going to pretend I didn't even hear that. Just get out of here.
All right, man.
And don't, the turkey sandwiches on the left, do not eat one. Send in Tootie. From the facts of life, Tootie.
Not the other Tootie?
If this doesn't work out, that's it. He's got to get a job. He's got to start paying his own cell phone bill. Tom has not been our nanny for a little bit now, and I'm not quite sure what Tom's job is, except maybe stealing change from my pockets, and I think he may be selling my clothing on eBay.
There's just, it's just such like a tough road. Why even do it?
My mom passed away about 14 years ago, and she was a creative person. She was a writer, and she wasn't like a comedian or a comedy writer, but she was really into comedy, and she was into writing. She was a good writer, but I know that was something she was really into, and she stopped. And I always kind of got the feeling that she regretted stopping. And I think that's why when I was, you know, became creative and had that kind of, like I had an outlet, like it seemed like I had some talent creatively, I wanted to pursue it because I had seen that she regretted maybe stopping pursuing it. So I feel like I've been trying to, you know, keep this dream alive, you know, to keep her, you know, my promise to her alive.
When do you finally give up on, like, a dream? When do you finally stop pursuing a dream that you've had for so long? Well, what do I do now? Like, was that it for me? Maybe that was all the success I'm gonna have.
They never branch out into other genres of weed movies, so I'm gonna change that. I'm writing a weed horror movie. It's called I Have No Idea What You Did Last Summer.
There's a lot of people who do comedy and never became famous. You know, they had some success, and it's just kind of like, what happens to those people? What, you know, I never see a documentary really focusing on those people, like the many comedians that are still practicing their art and like really trying to make a go of doing stand-up probably won't be ever become hugely famous, but what happens to them, you know?
I'm like, when's this gonna happen, you know? And so there was that delusion.
It's weird, like when you think you're supposed to do something. I didn't think it would take that long. I just thought this is what you were meant to do.
Yeah, you feel trapped at times. Like it is scary.
Salmon steak, salmon cakes, salmon croquettes, any type of fish sticks, anything like
that. Hey, get off your fucking phone, you piece of shit, asshole, fuck, dick, douche.
Okay, well that was the Letterman people and they wanted to book you, so.
You know what, dude? You know what, dude? This is, I'm sick of your shit. You know that show you booked me on last night?
No, what
show?
That was.
You don't remember? There's the only show you've gotten me. The piece of shit show.
The one at the laundromat?
Yes, at the laundromat.
That's one of the best shows in New York, Tom.
How is that one of the best shows
it's
in New York?
It's amazing, all right?
No, it's not.
Aziz Ansari just did a drop-in the other night on it.
Was Aziz Ansari was there?
Well, he was doing his laundry, but he was there.
But he wasn't doing the show, dude.
It's a great show, Tom.
No, it's like, have you ever been to the show?
No, all right? I've seen pictures.
They don't even... Where have you seen pictures of this laundromat show?
I posted a few. I don't know. I photoshopped.
You know what, dude? This is, you know what? I'm sick of this shit.
All right, Tom.
I'm sick of your bullshit, man.
I'm done with this.
I'm done.
No. Come on, man. Your CD tape is in 3 days. I have industry coming.
I don't give it. You have industry coming? Who?
Well, it's not comedy industry. I have a guy I know from the textile industry. And the lawyer of the guy who shot Reagan is going to be there.
I don't understand. What is that gonna do for me? What is that gonna do for me?
It could do a lot for you. That guy's huge now, man.
You know what?
He's doing everything.
You know what, man? Fuck you. I am done with you. I can't believe you booked me on that show. It was a nightmare, and you weren't even there to support me about it.
What about the good times, Tom?
What?
You don't remember all the good times we've had?
All right, hey, before you go. I'm out of here, dude. I'm done. I'm not doing it.
Hey, look.
That was a paid gig the other night.
At the laundromat?
Yeah, you forgot to take it.
What is this?
Hey, whoa, I get 10.
Well, what is this?
It's dryer sheets.
Fuck you, man. Fuck you.
Wait, does this mean I can have all the dryer sheets?
Yes.
I knew this would be hard getting back into this, and I knew it wouldn't be an easy road, but it just, I feel like there's just so much bullshit I can't take anymore in this business and in the comedy world. I want to wash my hands. I don't even want to fucking deal with this anymore. It's just, I feel like I try so hard and I give so much and you get nothing in return. I remember why I stopped doing it. I guess I'm just getting to that point where, like, I have to accept that, you know, my dreams aren't going to come true like I thought they were. You know, like, I'm not going to win an Oscar, you know, like I promised my mom, and I'm not going to get blown by Scarlett Johansson on the toilet like I promised my dad and my mom. You know, I told them that one day that would happen, but when you're a kid, no one tells you your dreams can't come true. You think they will. So it's sad to think, you know, there have to be a bunch of 4 or 5 year olds out there right now who have a dream that Scarlett Johansson might blow them while they're on the toilet. And, you know, it's not going to happen for most of them.
But it's like being this fucking funny and hilarious and original is like this curse that I was given. Because, you know, like, some people are, like, really good at math or this. It's like, I was given this, like, amazingly great sense of humor. But, like, what do you do if you can't get paid to be, you know, good at what you're doing, which is being funny and making, you know, jokes about farts and balls, which I'm really good at. Like, I'm great at doing that. But, I mean,
there's a point where you just essentially decide, I don't give a fuck what anybody thinks anymore. I'm just going to do what pleases me. And that just takes a confidence, which comes from failing so much that you realize that failing won't kill you.
I don't know how to do anything. Like, I can't fix cars, and I don't know how to operate on people, you know, and I don't crunch numbers, and I don't, you know, I'm not that great with computers.
At one point, I was like, this is dumb. This right. is not fun. When comedy doesn't get fun for me, I don't want to do it anymore. So,
you know, it's not the hard part of it is just like sticking around, man, because it sucks.
I can find a job, but man, it would suck. Sitting under those long lights. What are those, halogen lights?
Yeah.
Ugh. Just waiting to be like, is this a day? Is this a day that I can kill myself?
I was getting older. Doors have closed. To you.
I was like, I'm done, I'm out, I'm going.
I'm fucking done at this point. I don't give a shit about the CD. I don't give a shit about comedy.
Tom, it's Scott calling again. Please call me back when you get a chance, man. Tonight's the big night. I want to make sure you've got everything. I can't stress enough how important it is that you actually show up and do the show. We booked the venue, okay? We've got 150 people showing up. And I've put a couple $1,000 into the production already, so please give me a call back. Put me at ease here. It'd be a shame if you just blew the whole thing off and quit the game completely, you know? Everyone's got their breaking point, I guess. I'm gonna go get high.
I owe you an apology. Yeah, you left last time, you were a little mad at me, I was a little mad at you, I get it. But that was before I knew your album was brilliant.
What?
Brilliant. And I don't throw this around a lot, I'm gonna say genius.
What did you like best about it?
I didn't listen to it, but I know that the offers coming in are cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. They want you to be the new Spider-Man. We just heard his album, we wanna make him the new Spider-Man. I'm like,
they want me to be Spider-Man?
Are there jokes about Spider-Man? And they're like, no, we just felt the tone was perfect.
To be Spider-Man.
For you to be
Spider-Man.
Has
that ever happened before where someone just did a comedy
album? I was trying to talk them out of it. I was like, you should at least let him audition. And they were like, no, we don't want him to audition. We want to make him Spider-Man. Steven Spielberg, Nora Ephron, the Coen brothers.
What about them?
Roman Polanski.
What about them?
They all called together and they were like, hey, do you represent Tom McCaffrey? And I'm like, who's asking? And they're like, Spielberg, Scorsese, Efron, Soderbergh, Polanski, we're all here. We want to direct a movie called Coolest Guy Ever, starring
and
Tom
that's
McCaffrey.
All. But Roman Polanski isn't even allowed to come here.
He's on his way here now so he could serve his jail time and make sure he's out in time to direct this movie. The Academy Awards call,
yeah.
They were like, we heard Tom McCaffrey's album. We want to create an award called Funniest Album of the Year and award it to Tom McCaffrey this
They're
year.
They're gonna make an award that has nothing to do with movies?
They're not even gonna nominate other people. Just you.
Right.
Has nothing to do with movies. They're gonna give you two Oscars for the award.
Are you serious?
I was like, they only give one, right? When you know when they're doing thing? And I haven't seen the Oscars, but they hand people a statue. They're gonna give you two statues. They're gonna make you dance after that.
I'm gonna dance?
They're gonna give you a dance number,
You mean the dance that I did from when I was a kid?
They're gonna give you that dance back.
They're gonna let me do that?
They're gonna let you, I know they own the rights to it. They're gonna let you do that dance again. I was like,
why?
Do you remember that? And they were like, we talk about it every year. We're like, wait, we can't find that kid. Where is that kid?
They've been looking for me to
They've
do that?
They've been looking for you.
That's oh my God, this is
the
insane.
Album,
I knew it, I knew
they
it.
They didn't even know it was you until they heard the album and were like, this reminds us of something. And they were like, what does this album
That's
remind
so
us of?
That's so weird, I wasn't even talking when I danced.
It was the essence, they said.
Right, really?
They were like, is this the kid
well, that makes sense.
Who nailed a dance number like 20 something years ago? And I was like, I guess. I don't know. I don't.
That's
I haven't watched his material yet.
Well, that's great, man. That's great.
Well, it's not all. They're like, how about an 18 picture deal for Tom McCaffrey?
18 movies?
18 movies.
Just from the album.
They were like, we trust that this guy can make 18 movies. No problem.
Is anyone else going to be
No problems. Them? No, it's just you.
Just
You're going to play all the roles in every movie. Cate Blanchett agreed to star in all of them opposite you.
Really?
Yeah.
She's already on board.
Already on board.
Did she hear the album?
No. She heard them talking about the album.
So even people are just hearing
They quoted
hearing
your
about-
jokes. The New York Times called.
Yeah.
They want to do an article called Tom McCaffrey is Funnier Than Louis C.K.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Guess who's going to write it?
Who?
Louis C.K.
Louis C.K.'s writing the article
Louis
about how
C.K.'s
I'm better than him?
Louis C.K.
Has
wants
he ever
to write
done
it.
That before?
He's never done it, because you know what? He's what? Quitting comedy.
Why?
He's like, I can't write jokes anymore. How am I going to write jokes anymore? He's done all the jokes I can do.
You mean my album?
Your album made him quit comedy.
Oh my God, that's
I was like,
that's weird.
I was like, that's a bad decision. He's like, I have no choice.
Why are you telling
Tom McCaffrey's
all...
better. I was like, what?
This what? Is weird. When did you what? Get? When did you get all these calls?
I got them all one after another about 2 hours ago. This guy named Showbiz called.
Yeah.
He wants to give you the rich and famous plan. I was like, what's that? He's like, it was from the Muppet movie. We want to make it real. Scarlett Johansson called. She wants to blow you.
Scarlett Johansson wants
Scarlett
to blow
Johansson me. Called me on this phone. I was like, who is this? And she was like, Scarlett Johansson. I'm like, come on. And she said it again. And I was like, oh, hey, Scarlett Johansson.
Just for saying
you know what
again?
She said? She said, I heard this guy's album, I need to blow him. This is unprecedented.
This is unbelievable. She's never
a
done that
famous
before?
Famous actress hears a stand-up comedy album, calls his manager, the manager of the comedian in the album, and says, I want to blow that guy. She wants me to drop a contract to make sure that you don't decide to get blown by some other actress.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'll be taking 10% of that blowjob, which I'm really excited about. But I didn't tell you the best part of all. You're doing Ferguson.
Are
Greg
you fucking
Ferguson?
Serious?
Yes!
Yes!
Yes,
I did it,
dude.
I did it.
You're doing Ferguson.
Oh,
I
yes!
can't believe it.
That is amazing.
I know.
When?
I know.
When am I doing it?
Well, they don't have a date yet. You're going to submit tapes. If they like your set, they'll get you in.
Like thunder and lightning. Hot damn, it's so exciting. It hits you like a hammer. Electric slammers.
Great time for you right now.
It is?
This is a great time. There's heat.
There's heat?
Buzz. You know how many times a day I pick up this phone and it's like, Tom McCaffrey. None. But I will soon. Once everything...
Can we go back to that?
Check the man on Trophies Weather Channel. Holy hail coming down, better rock a flannel. Chill factors with a chance of sleet. Vortex raincoats with no leaks. Eastern Standard Mountain Time. Big Rob rocks a funky rhyme. Central and Pacific zones. Fresh forecast on the microphone. Like thunder and lightning. Hot damn, it's so exciting.
Girls are different from guys. And it's weird to people.
Yeah, yeah. Is that your joke?
That's exactly it. Girls are so.
So you saw the last Comic Standing episode too?
I saw it on Lena.
No doubt. Talking jet streams, new streams, chopper. Yeah, man, it's gonna be a monster. Lock it down like Fort Knox. You giving me eyes like Don Knotts. Ain't a robot, weatherman. Meteorologist with the jam. Eastern Standard Mountain Time. Big Rob rocks a funky rhyme. Central and Pacific zones. Fresh forecast on the microphone.
That's it. This show is big.
Who else is on it?
Dick Clark is on it.
Dick Clark, he's dead.
He's playing a ghost, Tom. It's about ghosts attacking people.
So he's one of the ghosts?
He's one of the ghosts, man. It was hard to get him.
I'm not counting sheep, stay up late counting pollen. Nor'easter bunny cat buried your island. Going eye to eye with the eye of the storm. Control weather patterns with an app on my phone. Shipwreck your vessel, suck through a funnel.
They're gonna bring Roman Polanski in. He's like, I'm gonna get arrested for this. Right. I have never felt more passionate about a project than I do about this.
Just from hearing my album?
Heard your album. He is coming over on the next flight. He's gonna do his jail time and then make sure that he's out in time to direct this movie with all those people.
Damn, it's so exciting. It hits you like a hammer. Electric slammers, Doppler radar stampers. Strong winds coming in, flipping over campers, weekend dampers.
The sandwiches on the right, the table, don't eat those.
I already had one.
Then go in the bathroom and you throw it up. Stick your finger down your throat and you throw it up. Send in Tootie! From the Facts of Life, Tootie!
Not the other Tootie?
Don't give me Blair!
Down better rock a flannel. Chill factors with a chance of sleet. Vortex raincoats with no leaks. Eastern Standard Mountain Time. Big Rob rocks a funk.
There's more.
What, there's more than this.
There is more.
What?
This girl, Susie Call. From your junior high.
Yeah.
She wants to get back together. Apparently, she's some girl that broke your heart. She wants in. The Weinsteins called. They want to set you up with an 18-picture deal.
They do?
And they're restarting Miramax.
They are?
They're bringing back Miramax.
Just from my album?
For your 18-picture deal, but based on the album.
There's
you wrote.
Less than 18 tracks on the album.
Less than 18 tracks. They were like, we trust that this guy can make 18 movies. No problem.
Is anyone else going to be
No problems. Them? No, it's just you.
Just
You're going to play all the roles in every movie, like Eddie Murphy. You're going to play.
Shipwreck your vessel, suck through a funnel. Stranded on an island filled with bridges and tunnels. Slip on black ice and throw out your hip. Here's a glass of acid rain, have a sip. How is it outside? Don't ask Dan Rather. He'll tell you the news, now spit back the weather. Atmospheric pressure, Mr. Freeze.
No effort.
Winter is coming. Make it snow in the desert. 5-day forecast, my outlook's extended. 60 bars of rhymes, my weather verse is ended. Like thunder and lightning. Hot damn, it's so exciting. Morning, morning, don't fly a kite then. Lyrics storming, beat is frightening.
Yeah, TNC back, bitches. Yeah, less money, more problems. I'm about to start rapping. Yeah, ain't paid my cable bill in 15 months. The ATM says I have insufficient funds. My money problems are really stressing me out. Day and night, yeah, it's all that I think about. I look for money in the cushions of my couch. Me and Bill Gates ain't got nothing in common. To save money, I'm eating my top ramen. Got less possessions than the Dalai Lama. And I'm more broke than Jenna Jameson's hymen. Got no checks coming in and my life is hell. I'm handing out IOUs at fucking Taco Bell. Got no cash and things are going fucking awry. Every night I pray that my rich uncle will die.
What?
Went to a hooker who looked like Robert De Niro. She wanted 30 bucks for sex, I was like, how about zero? Was stealing internet from my neighbor Bjorn. He moved, now I can't look at online porn. No more porn, I jerk off to glamour. Going bankrupt faster than MC Hammer. Used to steal from Target, but now they're on to me. Puffing so much weed, I should move to the Honda Lee. Losing mad sleep due to this fucked up economy.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
At the club, my credit card gets declined.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
So poor, can't even afford to spend time.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Second verse, it only gets worse. Listen up, bitches, I'm about to start rapping again. Yeah. My credit's a joke, I got mad money gripes. Owe more back taxes than Wesley Snipes. Other day someone asked me how was my portfolio. I said good, even though I don't know what the fuck is a portfolio. My funds are retarded like Cuba Gooding in radio. Can't afford health insurance, but that's okay, yo. When I get a fever, I pray it goes away, yo. I went to a chateau, but I didn't have enough dough. So I went to the bathroom, climbed out the window. Collectors on my ass about my student loan. When they call my phone, I say that Tom ain't home.
Hello.
Don't even try and fuck with my money. Homes. I'll drop your ass faster than the fucking Dow Jones. Don't have enough to buy or even lease. Last week I borrowed a dollar from my 4-year-old niece.
Damn.
Didn't pay her back and her mama's irate. Got 99 problems, they're all money related.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Can't get an apartment without a cosign.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Been bouncing mad checks and now I'm getting fine.
Got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
On a date with me, you won't get wine or dine.
Got my mind on my money.
And my sister pays my cell phone bill. Yeah, bitches, I'm broke as fuck in this shit. Yeah, if you feel me, throw your food stamps in the air. Yeah, things aren't going that well for me right now. Yo, so don't steal this track. I need the money, know what I'm saying? Yeah, if I see your ass, I'll borrow a dollar and I'll pay it back. I can't even afford to pay the dude that's recording this track.
Wait, what?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you hear that?
Just get out of here, man.
Do you validate parking by any chance?
Now let me tell all you fools one thing. I got bad knees, so I won't be crumping. Walking upstairs gets my heart pumping. I guess it's just because I'm 30-something.
I get heartburn when I eat food that's spicy. I'm right on the verge having a midlife crisis. My favorite actor is Andre Brower. Afraid of teens on the train during rush hour. Like to watch Jeopardy while drinking whiskey sours. Every morning I lose hair in the fucking shower. Talking about politics gets me really antsy. Everybody's telling me I need a VN. Starting to read books written by Tom Clancy. When the movie's too loud, I get really annoyed. I have to worry now about things like hemorrhoids. Lactose intolerant, so milk I do avoid. Taking pills to help me with my thyroid. Teenage girls are starting to call me sir. And pains in my joints are starting to occur. All my friends are moving way out to the birds. And my motherfucking 20s are a total blur. On my life, I'm now starting to reflect. And every 6 months, I have to get my prostate checked. High cholesterol, so I can't eat bacon when I sex.
Yeah.
My lower back starts to ache and get acid indigestion when I eat a year. I'm starting to freak out by turning big 4-0.